Hello everyone, this is Digital Electronic Circuit class, that is EC252 is the subject. Today we will do about logic families. Now, first we will do what are the characteristics of logic families. First is fanin. Fanin, that is how many number of inputs one gate can handle. You can see it is given, fanin is the number of input connected to the gate without any degradation in the voltage level. So maximum how much number of input one gate can handle sufficiently, that is called fanin. Fan out, that is how many number of gate one gate can handle, that is the output portion. It is given, fan out specifies the number of standard loads that the output of the gate can drive without impairment of the normal operation. Simply, one gate can handle how many number of gates, that is fan out. Power dissipation, whenever we are doing the operation, what are the power is dissipated, that is power dissipation. Propagation delay, that is when the input changes and the output changes, the difference is propagation delay. That means what is the time required to input to propagate to the output. Noise margin, there is the maximum noise voltage added in an input signal of a digital circuit that does not cause an undesirable change to the circuit output. It simply means that whatever the maximum possible noise it can handle without disturbing the proper output. So this is fan out, one gate can handle how many gate. This is fan in, how many number of input can be handled by one gate. This is the delay, that input has been changed from 0 to 1 50% to output change 1 to 0 50%. This change is, we say, propagation delay, high to low, and the opposite, this is called propagation delay, low to high. Now coming to the logic families, the most useful logic families, they are TTL, ECL and CMOS. These three is the most usually and most efficient logic families. Now first we coming to the TTL. The TTL, it is based on bipolar transistor, so that means it is BJT based. Operation. One of the most widely used families for small and medium scale devices, rarely used for VLSI. Typically operated from 5 volt supply. Typical noise immunity is about 1 to 1.6 volt. Many forms, some optimized for speed, power, etc. High speed version comparable to CMOS, that is 1.5 nanosecond is the speed. Low power version down to about 1 milliwatt per gate. This is the power consumption. Now this is the example of the TTL NAND gate. So we can see input A is this one, input B this one. So this is multi emitter gate. We can see here it is two gate, two emitter is there in the gate. So this is the operation. Input terminals, that is emitter of Q1, and output terminals, that is the collector of Q2. This is the Q2. So now we will take the operation when any input equal to logic 0. So any one of these, if it is logic 0, then Q1 emitter junction is forward biased. Also its collector junction is forward biased. So Q1 goes in saturation. So this goes to saturation if any one input is at logic 0. So we can see it is given to the base of Q2. That means base of Q2 is at low voltage. This cause base emitter junction of Q2 to be reverse biased. So Q2 goes in cutoff. So this is cutoff. Hence output is 5 volt or logic 1. So here the output, it is connected to the VCC and it is disconnected to the ground. When all inputs at logic 1, so that is the second case, then Q1 emitter junction is reverse bias, because how many inputs are there? All are at logic 1. If all are at logic 1, then this one, there is a first transistor, that is Q1, emitter junction is reverse bias, so Q1 goes to cutoff. Its collector voltage increases as it goes to cutoff. This forward bias Q2, so Q2 goes to saturation. Now this time this is saturation, and as this is saturation, output is 0 volt. So this is connected, so output is connected to, as this is connected, output is connected to ground. So output is at 0 volt. This is the example of DTL NAND gate with open collector output. It is similar to the previous circuit. Q2 is used as an emitter follower. So we can see here Q2 is emitter follower. Output of Q2 is fed to the input of Q3. Here you can see this output is fed to the input of Q3. Collector of Q2 and Q3 are in phase. This we can see. And this circuit needs an external pull-up resistor between output and the power supply. This is this one. The disadvantage of open collector gate is their slow switching speed. The pull-up resistance is few kilo ohm. It gives a relatively long time constant when multiplied by the stray output capacitance. Is worse when output goes from low to high. TTL NAND gate with totem pole, that is active pull-up. In this circuit, Q1 and the 4 kilo ohm resistor act like a 2 input AND gate. The remaining circuit acts like an inverter. Transistor Q3 and Q4, you can see these two form a totem pole, that is one NPN transistor in series with another. When a totem pole output state either Q3 or Q4 is on, any one of this is on. If A or B is low, this is the two input we can see. If any one of these are low, the Q1 conducts the base voltage of Q2 is almost 0. Q2 is cut off, hence if this is cut off, then Q4 goes into cut off, and because it is fed into this, Q3 base is high and Q3 acts as emitter forward, the output Y is high. Y we are taking so as the output, and as this T3 or what we write Q3, its base is high, so it is acting like a emitter forward. TTL NAND gate with totem pole active puller, if A and B are high, Q1 does not conduct or it is cut off, so it goes to cut off. Q2 base goes high, that is saturation. This is saturation. Q4 goes into saturation, hence output is low. It is saturation, so it is connected to ground, so the output is connected to ground, so output is low. Totem pole transistor produces a low output impedance. When Q3 is conducting, the output impedance is approx 70 ohm. When Q4 is saturated, the output impedance is only 12 ohm. Hence, the output impedance of a totem pole circuit is low. This is the speciality of totem pole circuit, output impedance is low. Any stray output capacitance is rapidly charged or discharged through the low output impedance. Hence, the output can change quickly from one state to the other. This is the types of TTL. Standard TTL, the typical gate propagation delay of 10 nanosecond and a power dissipation of 10 milliwatt per gate. For a power delay product or switching energy of about 100 picojoule. Now coming to the low power TTL, it is slow switching speed about 33 nanosecond. Reduction in power consumption, that is 1 milliwatt, and now specially replaced by CMOS logic. Coming to high speed TTL, it is faster switching than standard TTL, it is 6 nanosecond, but significantly high power dissipation, 22 milliwatt. It is milliwatt. Next is Schottky TTL, it is denoted by S. Use Schottky diode clamps at gate input to prevent charge storage and improve switching time. A Schottky diode has a very low forward voltage drop of 0.15 to 0.45 volt approx. Silicon diode has a voltage drop of 0.6 to 1.7 volt for comparison. The lower voltage drop can provide higher switching speed, faster speed of 3 nanosecond, but at higher power dissipation, about 19 milliwatt. Next, low power Schottky TTL, it is given as LS. Use the higher resistance values of low power TTL and Schottky diodes to provide a good combination of speed, that is 9.5 nanosecond, and reduced power consumption, that is 2 milliwatt, and PDP of about 20 picojoule. So, after TTL, we are now coming to ECL, that is emitter coupled logic. Here it is based on bipolar transistor but removes problem of storage time by preventing the transistor from saturating. Very fast operation, propagation delay of 1 nanosecond or less. its power consumption is very high, perhaps 60 milliwatt per gate, low noise immunity of about 0.2 to 0.25 volt, used in some high speed specialist application, but now largely replaced by high speed CMOS. This is one diagram using this one. So we can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 transistor is given in this diagram. Now we will discuss this, the input and output section. The input is at base of transistor. The emitter of T reference the different transistor, this is given as TA, TB, TC, okay, and this is the T reference. So this transistor is of our cup of tea. That T reference, this one, the emitter of T reference and input transistor couples together. Hence, we are giving this name. ECL, basic gate is OR or NOR gate. If any input is not connected, the transistor TI base emitter will be at cutoff. Therefore, it will be taken as low logic level. Now coming to the output section, the output T OR and T NOR are taken from the emitters of each transistor. Connector of T OR and T NOR connects to ground in the CC amplifier mode, also called emitter follower mode. The emitter gives the output, which also connects to VEE, minus VEE actually, through a resistor that is 1.5 kilo ohm. So you can see minus VEE is connected to 1.5 kilo ohm here. This is the differential amplifier. There is transistor T which forms a differential amplifier pair between T and the parallel circuits of TA, TB and TC. T gets the input reference voltage VR minus 1.15 volt from a reference supply circuit. The pairs amplifies the difference of base voltage of TA or TB or TC and V reference. The emitters of the differential amplifier pairs connect through a common resistance RE, that is almost 1.8 kilo ohm, and to the minus VE, that is almost minus 5 volt. Next, emitter follower, it is also common collector amplifier. The collector of TA, TB, TC, etc. are also common collector of the differential amplifier pairs connect through a resistance RC, and it is at the order of 267 ohm to the ground. Now the working of it, consider TC and TREF from the circuit. We can see case 1, that is, let all Vin equal to minus 1.6 volt, but Vref equal to minus 1.15 volt. So Vin is low and Vref logic high. So TC is in cutoff and Tref is normal inverting mode. So TOR gets minus 1.1 frame hold, that is logic low. It is cut off. Y equal to minus VE, that is low. And case 2, if V at TC is minus 0.7 volt high, Vref equal to minus 1.15 volt, that is low. TC is normal inverting mode and Tref is in cutoff. Minus VE is reflected at T0. So T0 is cutoff, Y equal to minus VE, that is logic low. TR is on, so Y equal to 0 volt, that is also low. Now coming to the features of ECL, it is giving faster speed, that is 2 nanosecond propagation delay of operation than TTL, which was 10 nanosecond, and 74S TTL 3 nanosecond. It is having more power dissipation, 50 milliwatt per gate than TTL, which was 10 milliwatt, and 74S is 19 milliwatt. And noise margin at 1 or 0, output and input equal to 0.4 volt. It was minus 1.7 volt and minus 1.4 volt. So this is some features of it. We first taken the TTL and next ECL, and we will continue. Thank you.